Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to demonstrate and describe about the Universal PLC platform with HMI. In this, we are using a Universal PLC, which is a programmable logic controller, and we will do the communication and programming of the PLC, and then we also communicate this PLC with the HMI. PLCs and HMIs are the backbone of the right now industrial systems. In the industrial arena and the industrial environment, PLC and the HMIs are the basic and the very essential systems nowadays, which are required to students to understand about them. So this is a basic kit to give the basic explanation about PLC and HMI and how the PLC and communication and HMI are working with the industrial environment. So we have described the different modules and install and design the different modules as per the requirements to study, to give the deep study and deep explanations about the PLC and how the other components will be working with the PLC and HMI modules. So this is the complete setup of four different modules, in which one is a switch SMPS panel, then we have a PLC IO panels, input output panels, then we have a HMI panel, and this is the LED relay DC motor lamp load panel. In this, there are different outputs and loads are given. HMI is for monitoring and controlling of the processes. PLC is the processing and the controlling of the process, and SMPS and switches panels are used to give the different inputs to the IO panels. Now I will describe the all panels one by one and what we are the different features all the panels. So we will start with the switch SMPS panels. So this is the switch SMPS panel. In this, we have used 10 toggle switches to give different input outputs as high and low, and these are the sockets. Similarly, T1 to T10, and these are the different inputs that can be provided to the PLC. Also, we are giving here the push switches. These push switches are momentary on-off switches, and when we push the switch, the value will be high, and then we release the switch, the value will be low. There is also a AC power source. The AC power source is connected behind the module. By this, you can forward all the supply to all the panels. These are already connected right now. And this is the AC bus here. When you want to AC connection any of the module, you can use the AC connection from these sockets. Also, there is a SMPS installed inside. This is converting the 230 volt AC to the DC power source of the 24 volt 2 amperes DC output, and this DC output is used to power all the 24 volt modules like PLC and HMIs. Similar, also they are using limit switch. The limit switch are the input devices for this. Common NO and NG terminals of this limit switch are provided on the front panel. Also, this is the proximity switch, the photo pickup type proximity switch. So this is the only output terminal of this proximity switch. When we sense any of the metallic object or the photo pickup type of proximity sense, and the output will be generated from this T19 terminal. This will be connected in the input sources, input processes. And this is the 24 volt bus. This is connected with the PLC and other modules. And this is the variable DC supply from 0 to 10 volt. So this is used to vary the supply as per the input and scaling purposes. Now we move on to the PLC IO input output panel. In this, there is a PLC with 16 modules and 16 inputs with 4 analog outputs and with 2 analog . Now we move on to the PLC IO panel. In this, there are 16 nodes of digital input and 14 nodes of digital output, and also 4 nodes of analog input and 2 nodes of analog output are provided. This PLC panel works with the 24 volt 3 ampere DC load ratings, and there is a Delta programming software is also provided, and COM port built in RS232 or RS485 ports compatible with the Modbus, ASCII and RTU protocol are provided with this PLC panel. Also, there is a HMI interface. D-pin 9-pin D-type connector is also provided to connect the HMI socket, but we will use the HMI to USB-C 232 cable to communicating with the HMI module. Now moving on to the HMI panel. This is the 7 inch 800 by at 480 pixels TFT LCD with 65,000 colors and 3 sets of COM ports and supports RS, which supports RS232, RS422 and RS485 communications, and RS232 USB port for data transfer and download. So this is the RS232 port. Beside the PLC and the HMI module are provided. In beneath the module, you can communicate the PLC or HMI with the programming and programming software. And this is the touch screen, compiles with IP68 certified, and editing software is DOP soft or is compatible with the operating system Windows XP, Windows 7. Other general routine purpose softwares can be communicated with this HMI software also. Now moving to the LED relay and DC motor lamp load panel. In this, 10 nodes of LED indicator for digital inputs are provided here. As we input provided, the LED display will glowing, and there is also 24 volt DC buzzer installed inside, and 24 volt DC motor is inside to give the proper visualizations of different modules and different components used in the industrial purposes. So this will be operated as per the programming you do. And these are the two relays for NO and NC, and common terminals are provided. These are the coil inputs of the relay, the input 1 and input 2, to provide and energize any of the relay you can use. There is also a lamp indicator of 230 volt AC which gives to output of any indications, and there is a lamp socket of 100 watt 230 lamp can be installed with this socket. So these are the input and output terminals. Sorry, the input terminals for line and neutral are provided for 230 volt AC lamp socket. So this is all about this relay panel and all the panels and modules described. All the panels are installed with a sturdy aluminium frame, so it will be easy and very neat and good looking design to understand and to easy communicate with all the panels. Now I am also showing the accessories. In accessories, we are offering a USB serial cable to communicate and to program the PLC, and also a USB to USB 2 port to communicate the and program the HMI also. There is also set of 4mm banana pin, 2mm banana pin connectors to do all the connections as per the programming requirements. Now we move on to the first programming explanation. According to the manual, user manual is also provided to do all the programmings as per the requirement, and we will follow the user manual and then we communicate and do the connections to do all the HMI communication and PLC communication to understand the universal PLC platform. So this was the basic description of all the system of this universal PLC platform with HMI. So the order code for this module and this setup is 19204246.7. You can query and operate, and you can query and to do any of the description and specification. You can use this code to find out the all details about this product. So you can also contact to www.tescaglobal.com, which is our new website, to do search about this product. So the experiment one of this PLC module setup is to study the PLC software installation. So we required a software to programming of the PLC. So the all steps of installing the software procedure of IPS soft. You can use the IPS soft of Delta Mac software to communicate and program this PLC, and also you can use the WPL soft. Both the software are compatible with the PLC. Now these are the all steps. You can follow these steps to install the software properly. Also there is an installation of procedure of communication manager. So communication manager software will also be provided with this module. You can easily install the communication module manager and all the softwares to do the communication system. Now I will explain you the communication establishment between PLC and computer system. So we will now do the communication establishment as per the procedure given in the user manual. Now to establish the communication between PLC and computer, we will follow this procedure. In this, this is asking to connect AC supply to the switch SMPS panel that we have already connected. Then connect T26, T27 of switch SMPS panel to 24 volt T1 and ground T2 of the PLC IO panel that is already connected inside panel. Now we will connect the communication cable or the serial connector. Connect one end of the cable to serial connector and other end of the PS2. So we will first connect the PS2. This is the PS2 cable, the serial communication cable for programming, and this will be connected with the connector provided on the PLC module. Properly align the connector and then gradually and very slowly push it inside the connecting module. So after proper aligning the connector, you can easily install this connector to the PLC module. Now this is the other end of the communication and programming cable. So this is the serial connector. If you have serial port in your PC, you can use it directly, and if you do not have serial port, as I do not have the serial port in my PC, so I will use this serial to USB converter to converting the interface and to programming. So I am using the serial to USB converter. This serial to USB converter can easily be available in any computer market, so you can use this to communicate and to do programming of the PLCs. So this is the 3 meter long cable to programming, so this can be easily used. So I will connect this to the USB port of the PC. Now we will open the COM manager first, and then we do as described in the following procedure. Now we will open the COM manager. COM manager has been already installed. This software will also provided to you with the setup, and when we reach the COM manager, we will open COM manager. The COM manager's fast icon is already provided here also. You can open this from here also. Now we will open the COM manager. So this is the COM manager. Now we will first press add and the driver settings and driver properties should be same. These are also given in the user manual. So these are the driver properties. This should be proper as given in the user manual. So we have done our driver properties. Now we have to select the COM port, that the USB to serial COM port is COM3 in my PC. So whatever your COM port will be showing, accordingly you have to select the proper COM port for this. Now we will press auto detect and node ID will showing 0 and press OK. Now this will working and auto detect the PLCs. So you can see this is the message showing detecting is successful. So this has been detected our PLC. Now we'll press OK and again press OK. So this is the driver and properties, and this is our PLC address and configuration are provided on the COM manager. So our PLC has been connected. Now for adding the simulator driver also, we will press add again, and this is the driver 2 name, and in this RS232 the type will be selected as the DVP simulator. So that we have selected the DVP simulator, and then we will set the device settings and press OK. Here you can see the one device is working at time. So this is the start, the driver 1, which is our PLC, is start right now. We can start as well this also. So simulator requires to need allow access from the administrator. So we will allow access, and the simulator will also be start. You can also delete and configure this to start and stop all the PLC accordingly. So this is about the communication of the PLC. Now we will go to close this communication manager, and then we will go to install the IPSoft 3.0, the PLC software. Also there are two softwares provided, WPLsoft and IPSoft. So these are the main software to programming the PLCs. I have already installed this software in the PC. You can see the procedure given in the user manual to install the IPS soft in your PC properly. So this is the IPS soft 3.0 software for programming. This describes to install how to install the software inside the PC. Now this is the experiment number 2. We will first do the programming to study the basic operation of PLC trainer, and then we communicate and then download the program after compiling, and then we test the run of the programming. So we will on the IPS soft in the computer by clicking on this icon. The IPS soft will be start in few seconds. And this will showing our last programming section that we have done doing with this. Now we will first press file and new to create a new project. Now we will give name to the new project, which is we will first doing the AND gate module, and in this we will select the controller type is DVP and PLC type as SS2. This is our the PLC type and PLC module, so this should be in proper when we working with this PLC. So this is the model number of the PLC, you can consider it as a model number, and I will press OK. This is showing the project already exists in the directory that I have already designed this project. So we will press OK to replace this, and now we will configure new project. Now first we will go to program, press new. So this is our later create program section window. In this we will give any POU name to the program as required, and press select this to the cyclic task, and language will be used to the ladder logic. So the ladder diagram will be used in this programming section. You can also use instruction lists, sequential flowchart. These are the different programming language. I am only explaining you the ladder diagram for this PLC purpose. Now press OK. This will give you a window to programming the program to the PLC, the AND gate program. Now after opening this window, we will first zoom out to proper alignment. Now first we can do the logical symbol programming also, and you can directly do the programming by selecting the any of the element. This is the NO contact for this. So this is the NO contact. Now as we reach to this red dotted box, this will show you how to use this direct NO block. So we have to use NO block in the line. So we'll press enter, and we will again use NO block as we are using AND gate operation. So in the programming we have to do this program. Now we'll press escape by the PC to going to the select mode. Now we will double click on the address bar, and here we will enter X0, which is our first input for the type. So this is the identifier name here giving, and now we will add the address. So refer device address should be X is for input, and the device number, the address number will be 0, and press OK. Now press OK. So this is our first variable. Now for the second variable, we will use X1 and press enter. And this is the normally open contact that we are using right now. And now for giving the output, we will go to the coil output, and we will enter the coil in line with this program. So that is the output is provided. Now to add the output value, we will enter Y0 is our first output of the PLC. Now this our AND gate program has been done. Now we will compile this program by going to the compile section upper side on the window. So this is the compile, and go to compile option. So this has been compiled, and if we find any of the error, this will showing at the message box on the below area of the programming layout. So there are no errors in the our program. So our program has been completed successfully. Now we can download this program to the PLC. For downloading the program, we go to PLC and press transfer, and then there is two option provided, upload and download. So we need to download the program to PLC. So we will download program pressing the download. Here invalid driver or comm manager not startup showing. So we will first again go to communication setting. Driver is selected one. We'll go to comm manager and stop the simulator driver, and we need driver configured as our selected driver is the PLC. So driver is okay. Now we will again try to download the program. Here PLC download all the objects and different blocks. Now we will press transfer to the PLC. After 100% done, the function cannot be executed in the run mode, as our PLC is right now in run mode. So we have to take actions to first do the stop of the PLC. So we'll press OK. This will automatically stop the PLC, download the program, and then again turn the PLC into the run mode. This is asking, do you want to back to the running state? So we want to do running state again, so we'll press OK. So our program has been downloaded, and now we'll press run with the software. So PLC run is confirmed by pressing OK. Now to do the online simulation, we will first press the online or control F4. So we will go to online mode by pressing this. So here you can see right now input 0 and input 1 is not high. So we will do the programming, and now we will do the wiring sections to communicate, then providing the X1 and X2, and then we will verify the AND gate table by the output sources. So we will do the electrical connections on the PLC panel. For programming sections, we will connect the switch SMPS input toggle switches to providing the input to the PLC. For this, we will use switch 1, and this will be connected with the X0. So X0 is the one input of the truth table and the AND gate diagram, and this is the switch 2. This will be connected with the X1. So these are the two inputs, A or B, to the logic diagram, and these are the low high signal from the toggle switches will be provided. Now for output, we will connect a patch code from Y0, as we defined Y0 as the output of the logic gate, and this will be connected with any of the LED display. So when the output, both the output is high, the output will be on, output will be high. So this is our truth table, so we will verify our truth table accordingly. So now at this time both the states are 0, so the output is 0 right now. Now I will on B. Now 0 and 1 are the output. Right now output is also 0. Now we will off this again and press high to the toggle switch. So output is right now also low. Now we will on the both the output. You can see the output is glowing. The output is showing at the LED relay panel. So this is how we verify our truth table of the AND gate. So this is the first basic program and basic ladder logic diagram of the universal PLC platform. You can do all the programs like OR gate, XOR gate. So I will explain you now the XOR gate program to do the connections and to do the proper programmings. So this is the experiment number 4, XOR gate. We will now do the ladder logics for the XOR gate program. You can follow the complete setup and complete process steps to do the new programming, to do the new program or the ladder logic by pressing the new file and then accordingly set all the values, all the drivers, and do the programming. Now I will just show you the editing in this program as well. Then we will do the complete programming as per the last. So this, after doing the all steps, you will reach there like this. Now I will explain you how to define the different variables. So x0 is already defined. Now we will define the x0 as a input. Here you can see. Now we will define again b input to providing, and address will be given x1 to this variable. Type is boolean and initial value should be false. Press OK. Now we will define output, which is the C output in the XOR section, and we will select here Y as the output and Y0 the address, and all the initial value and bool type should be same for this. Now we will do the programming by pressing the NO contact and reach to this green box, and as the red box indicates, this is the first X program, and again we will add two blocks here. Now as we require the NC section or the inverted NO latch here, now we will select here, and instead of normally open contact, we will use the normally closed contact for this. Now to parallel latching or parallel contacts, we will select and reach to the first block of NO. Here you can see, as you see the parallel design here right now, seeing the arrow, and when you reach on the block, you will see the parallel design and press click here, and this will add in the parallel. Now we will also need to add a block inside, so this is the block. Now for NO contact, we have to add the NO contact on the same line. This should be deleted. So this is our XOR gate ladder logic diagram. Now this should be inverted, so we will invert this program as well. Now for XOR input, we will define the different values, as we first give the input A and B to this. Similarly, input A and B to this, and now we will add the output coil to the section. So this is the output coil added. Now we will also press escape, given the address. This is the C. So identifiers and variables we have already defined, so there should be less time taken in the programming section. So this is how you do the when the lengthy programs are required. First we have to define all the variables accordingly, and then we program. Now we will compile this program. So compilation has been done, there is no error present. So now we will download this program. Now at this time, they make sure the initial values and all the elements should be ticked right. Now we will transfer program to the PLC. PLC is right now run mode. We will first stop the PLC, download the program, and then again place the PLC in the run mode. Press OK. Now program has been downloaded. Now we will online mode to see the simulation. Here you can see A and B is showing on. That's because the connections are already done in the simulation. So same connection will remain for the procedure. Here two inputs A and B are given, and output C will be come forward from the PLC. So this is how we do the wiring, same as the AND gate, as we require two inputs and one output. Now we will verify the truth table of the XOR gate. For this, when both the values are low, output should be 0, and both the values are high, output should be 0. So this is our logical programming. Now at this time, both the outputs are low, both the outputs are same, the output should be 0 right now. You can see the output is 0. Now I will turn on any of the outputs. So I will turn on the switch one high. You can see right now output is showing at the LED panel. Now again I close this output and turn the other one output high. You can see the 0 at the 01 input. On the both inputs, the output C will be high. Again I will high both the input. Here you can see the output is low. So when both the inputs are same, the output will be low. So this is how we do the programming of the XOR gate. You can also see the simulation on the programming section also. This is the online ladder logic programming. Here you can see right now A and B are both the on. When I off the A section, here you can see A is off, so the NC normally contact, normally close contact is showing on, and normally open contact is showing off. And when we off both the inputs, so both the inputs are changing. Now I will on any of the input, output is glowing, and when we on both the input, the output is off. So that's how we also observe the simulation of the programming. So PLC provides simulation environment also to do the proper programming before downloading it on the PLC. So this is about the programming of the XOR gate. You can understand the truth table. Now we will going to explain the HMI use in the universal PLC platform with HMI. So this is the HMI software which is also provided with this kit, and this is the Delta HMI software. This should be installed. The installation procedure also described in the user manual. So you can install the complete software to do the programming of the and communication of the HMI. The HMI cable I have also described earlier to do. Now we will do the establishment of communication between PLC, computer system, and HMI. To establish the communication PLC in computer, that I have already explained you. Now we will do the communication and establishment of the communication PLC and HMI panel. So HMI panel and communication will be described as per the software diagrams. Now first we have to download the software which is given the program to operate the HMI. The HMI program has been already designed accordingly to understand how the HMI works. So these programs and later for both the HMI and PLC communication is provided with the software. So now I will first download the PLC program, then we will download the PLC program with communication of PLC HMI. For downloading the sample program for the PLC communication, we will already given the ladder logic for sample program of the HMI communication with the PLC, how the HMI works. For this we will open the IPS software, and here we will go to open sections. In this we have already designed the Tesca HMI sample ladder. This will be provided with the kit, so we will open this ladder. So complete setup is given in the main program blocks. Here you can see the complete ladder logics already designed to do as per the HMI section. Now we will download this program to the PLC by pressing the download. Complete section should be downloaded. So this will download the program in the PLC, and then we will communicate the PLC with the HMI. Before that we will communicate the HMI and download the HMI screens inside the HMI. We have already downloaded the HMI. The downloaded sample will be provided to you. You do not need to do all the sections. The ladder logics should be downloaded when working with the HMI, this ladder logic sample, because the HMI will work when this ladder logic is downloaded inside the PLC. For working and practicing all the PLC, you can download different programs, but this particular program is required to download in the PLC for communication with HMI. Now we will minimize this and we will open the DOP soft. This is the software. The downloading and the installation processor is also given in the user manual to install the DOP software for the HMI. Now we will open this software. The DOP soft, the human machine interface software. Now we will open file, the HMI data Tesca. We will open this file, and this is the screens and the HMI components which I have already designed for the access. Now these screens and this program will be given. I already also describe you the different screens that I have made to communication. Now I will also explain you all the screen one by one. So these are the different screens. This should be downloaded to the HMI. For communication with the HMI, we will use the USB to USB 2 type cable. This is the cable, and this end will be connected to the HMI block. Beneath the HMI section, here you have to find the port and connect the HMI. Like this, and the other end will be connected with the PC. So after connecting the HMI with the PC, we will find the HMI and download the software to the HMI. So we will go to options, configuration. Here we have selected a new HMI, press OK, and we will go to download all data to the HMI. Here our data has been downloaded to HMI. The process is also done on the HMI as well, and the complete setup is also downloaded on the HMI. So all the screens can be visible now on the HMI. Now we will do the electrical connections, and also to communicate PLC with the HMI, we will use the serial cable that we are using to do the programming for the PLC. So the end of this serial cable will be connected with the PLC interface. So this will be connected with this socket. After properly tightened, you are ready to do the HMI process. If this does not connect, once switch off the supply and switch on the all supply of the HMI and PLC modules. So that our PLC has been communicated. Now we will do the electrical connections as described in the user manual, and then we see the HMI actions. Now after downloading the HMI and PLC program, the PLC HMI screens, and after communication establishment of the HMI and PLC, we will now do the connections. For this, given connect T1, T3, T5, T7 and T9 terminals of the switch block of the toggle switch will be connected with the input of PLC, which is X0, X1, X2, X3 and X4. So we will connect this as per given user diagram. So T1 will be connected with X0, T3 will be connected with X1, T5 will be connected with X2, T7 will be connected with X3, and last one, T9, will be connected with X4. So these are the different inputs for the HMI program and HMI layout. You can also remove the cable after downloading the program to the HMI. After downloading, this is not required. And now we will do the output connections with the output panel from the digital outputs and the inputs. Now we will connect Y0 with the T1 of the LED display, Y1 with the T2 of the LED display, T3 of the LED display. Now we will connect Y2 with the T5 and also Y3 with the T7 and the last one Y4 with the T5. So these are the output connections for the HMI to output panel. Now we will do the process as described to the HMI. I will explain you the process through the HMI. Now we will first see this screen on the HMI section. This is the Tesca home screen for this HMI program. Now press login, and in the login you will have to enter the account and password. So we will press to accounts window, press A D M I N. This is the touch screen HMI, so we have to press the admin here. This is the account, and press enter. Now we'll enter the password. The password required, the password is 1234 for this programming section, and we will press OK. And as we press OK, we will reach to the manual screen. The manual screen shows the different values on different windows. So first, this is the layout screen, status, manual and graph data. So we will first go to status screen. This is showing the status of all the inputs and output right now. Input X0, which is the emergency stop, is on. So I will off this input. Here you can see the input is off. So as I on the all inputs, the inputs are showing. Outputs are right now not showing because that we do not start the process in the manual. Now you will go to layout section. So this is a basic layout of a storage tank to tank 2. This is the auxiliary tank and this is the bin tank. The three tanks are derived here and defined here. So as the we first start the process, this will empty the tank in the wall. V1 and V2 are the Y2 and Y3 outputs that will be on when we provide the input X2 and X3, and then this will fill the tank, and after the filling is done, then we on the all other walls and we see how the process will done. Now for this, so now we will start the program, and first we will on the LM2. This is the LM2 limit of the X2 input. So as we on the X2 input, the LM2 limit shows that the tank is empty and this will start filling. Now as the limit reaches X1, we will give the X3 input. So this is showing that the tank is full, and after tank is full, both the walls has been closed, and Y1, Y4 is on. This is showing the filter is filling the bin tank, and after this tank is empty, this bin tank will be off. So right now we are using manual inputs. In the industrial purpose, this limit can be operated by different modules and different tank sections. Now that the bin tank is completely filled up, so we will now on the X4, the drain wall, to draining out the water completely. So this is showing that the water is completely drained out, and weighing machine also showing the weight of the water slightly decreasing, and after that the process should be completed. So process has been completed, so we'll press stop. So that's how the HMI and the communication works. Now we again go to home screen and enter the password and account. Password 1234. Press enter, press OK. Again, I have to enter the password. So the this is the resistive touch. This is not working properly with my nails are not pointed, so I am using the pen touch here. Press enter. Press OK. Now for manual operation, we will reach the manual screen. Now as I press the blower on, the blower will be on. This is the input from the HMI. You can see at the LED section, the blower LED is showing that the blower is on. Now as I press the off, blower off, this will off the blower. Similarly, the filter on, filter off, wall 1 on, wall 1 off, wall 1, wall 2 on, wall 2 off, wall 3 on and wall 3 off. So these are the different datas, and this is the graphical representation to graphical layout. We can also present the graph in the data log and also the data log options. So this is how we do the HMI and different programmings with the PLC communication. And HMI is very useful in the controlling of the industrial processes differently, and easily human can interface the machinery via easy responses. So this is all about the universal PLC platform with HMI communication. So this is all about the universal PLC platform with HMI. You can do all the programmings by different combinations by practicing the DL data logics of the different, all the different output modules can be used as the output on. You can use the output section as the relay to operating the different. There is also a DC motor provided to can operate with this 24 volt DC. For giving inputs, you can use the different input methods in which we, you can use the limit switches to giving the input similarly 24 volt by operating this process. So proximity switch can also be used to giving the different input methods. So you can study the deep understanding of the PLC and the process and HMI communication of the industrial purposes. So this is give you the deep and depth knowledge about the PLC and different modules and HMI also. So while working with this, you can also communicate and do all the programming methods also explained in the user manual while doing the programming and with the experiments. If you find difficulties, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the support. Thank you.